Hey everybody, this is Christian. Today I have another tutorial about certificate management for you because I actually never made a coherent video about how I'm managing my self-signed certificates in my local home network on Kubernetes. So that's what we are learning today. I will show how you can easily create and manage a certificate of authority in Kubernetes even without having a public domain or DNS record somewhere on the internet. And you can use this to generate and maintain self-signed certificates for all your applications in your local clusters. And because we're using Cert Manager, this also fits well in any kind of load balancer like Traffic or Nginx, whatever you want to use. So I hope this helps you when you're trying to make all your applications securely available through HTTPS in your local network. Let's go. But first, before we start with a tutorial, I want to show you the sponsor of today's video, Teleport. Because with Teleport, you can protect your Linux servers, web applications, databases, and Kubernetes clusters with two-factor authentication and an audit logging. In the coming weeks, I'll make a new tutorial about an upcoming version of Teleport, so that will introduce even more secure access features. I'm very excited about that to test it in my home lab. And if you're planning to use Teleport within your company environment, just reach out to the Teleport guys, and to get started for free, just download their community edition without any sign up or any payment. As always, you will find a link to their website in the description down below. Okay, so back to the topic. If you have a Kubernetes cluster running in your home lab or any local network and you want to expose your application securely through HTTPS, you have the problem or the task of managing trusted SSL certificates. For example, in my local K3S cluster, I have a couple of applications. Let's just pick a demo deployment called Nginx One that I want to expose via the hostname nginx1.clcreative.home. This is in my local network, and I have created an ingress object for it to route all traffic that comes to that hostname to the correct Nginx One servers. So when I open a web browser on my internal network and do a request to this address, it opens my application website. But as you can see, if you do this without a certificate resolver or inside a local network, you will always get a certificate warning when opening the website. And instead of just skipping this warning, I'm going to create a valid certificate for this demo project so my browser won't show this warning again and the connection will be trusted. To manage certificates inside Kubernetes, I'm using the free and open source tool Cert Manager. It's in my opinion the best and easiest way for certificate management in Kubernetes, and it's also independent of a load balancer, so you can integrate it everywhere, in traffic, in Nginx, it doesn't really matter, and it also works in HA scenarios, so that's pretty cool. If you don't know Cert Manager, I've made a separate tutorial video where I'm using it to manage certificates via Cloudflare DNS challenges. That's how I'm doing it in my cloud environments or when I'm using public domains. But you can also use Cert Manager to manage self-signed certificates that you have created manually. And they work in local networks without using any public domain or public DNS resolver. By the way, if you enjoy my videos and you want to support the channel here, make sure you leave a like and subscribe. That's telling YouTube to push my channel to more people, and it's really helping the channel growth, so that would be highly appreciated. Cert Manager is like most tools I'm covering here on my channel, free and open source, because I just love open source projects, and that can be installed via Helm in your Kubernetes cluster. Just add it to your repositories and install it. There is no configuration needed here because that's all done later with Kubernetes objects. Once you have Cert Manager running inside Kubernetes, you can then use it to create a certificate of authority and issue new self-signed certificates. And the best is that Cert Manager will be able to auto-renew these certificates before they expire, and you can also easily assign them to any ingress object that's used by your applications. Okay, so let's now start to do this. First, we need to generate a certificate authority. We will use the free and open source terminal tool OpenSSL to do that. I know some people might prefer using other tools, and we might take a look at some in the future as well. But for now, I want to show you the manual process. And in my opinion, that's the easiest way to get started with a simple CA that you can create yourself with two simple commands. So the first command here creates a private key for the certificate authority. We use OpenSSL to generate a new RSA key and output it to the file ca.key with a length of 4096. Now, in my old tutorial about self-signed certificates, I've also protected this key with a passphrase and AES encryption because this is a very sensitive key. But we later also want to easily import it into Cert Manager. So that's why I'm using no passphrase here for this key. Please make sure you store this file in a secure location. So once we have written that key to the file, we can generate a CX certificate from it by using this command. Request a new public CX certificate that's valid for 30 years and use our private key, the ca.key file, and output this to the file ca.crt. Then you also need to fill in some information like the organization name, the common name, your email address. Technically, it's not really needed for a local self-signed certificate, but if you want to identify this certificate later in the chain, it can be useful to fill in some reasonable information. And that was everything. So now we have a certificate authority that can generate self-signed certificates for us. Of course, you also want to make sure that your client trusts this CA so you later won't get this certificate warning again. So you need to import this certificate in the trusted root CA store of all of your clients that need to access the Kubernetes websites. So I've explained this in my previous tutorial about SSL certificates in a bit more detail and documented ways to import them into operating systems in my cheat sheets repo on GitHub. You will find that also in the description. But if you are on Windows, you can simply double click the CA cert file and just import it in the trusted root CA store of Windows. And most browsers will look up this store to trust your CA now, and then it's all good. So note, if you still get a certificate warning later, even when you imported this CA key, sometimes your browser needs a complete restart. Great, so now that we have prepared everything, we can start importing this CA into Cert Manager, and that's easily done by creating a new cluster issue object. Cluster issue objects are used in Cert Manager to generate and manage certificates. So when you create this, new certificates referenced by this cluster issuer will be signed by it. Sounds a bit complicated, but don't worry, it's actually pretty simple. So let's create a new Kubernetes manifest file for this cluster issue object, and let's call it nginx1-cluster-issuer. By the way, you can of course do the same thing with an issue object, but note, issue objects are always bound to specific namespaces. So that's why I'm using a cluster issue object. This can be used in my entire Kubernetes cluster in all namespaces. In the specifications, you can input details about this cluster issue object. For example, you can also use an ACMA server to generate a CA file here, but in case of a self-signed certificate, you just need to add a reference to a secret object that holds these two files, the CA key and the CACRT. But we haven't created it yet, so let's do that first. So this new secret manifest here stores the two files, the CA key and the CACRT. We call this object nginx1-ca-secret, and it needs to have two values where we put the content of the two files, one for the private key and one for the certificate. It's also important to store this not in the namespace of the project, but in the namespace where you have deployed Cert Manager. Otherwise, Cert Manager is not going to find that secret later when it needs to create the cluster issue object. Unfortunately, you can't just upload these two files or copy paste them. That would be too simple. You need to convert the content of the files with a Base64 encoding and make sure this output is using a one-line output. I haven't really found an easy way to do that in PowerShell under Windows, because the Base64 application you get on Windows is somewhat a bit different. So I just need to use my Linux machine here. If you know how to do that in PowerShell, please let me know in the comments. But I guess most of you are familiar with Linux anyway, so that shouldn't be a big problem for you. This command will output the content of the certificate file and pipe this into a Base64 encoder. And then we can just take this output and paste it into the content of our secret object value. Of course, you need to do the same for the certificate key as well and put this in the key value string. And then you can apply this Kubernetes secret to your Kubernetes cluster. And the secret now is ready to be used by our cluster issue object. So let's go back to this. And here we just need to put an information reference to the new CA secret object we've just created. So that's really all you need to create a cluster issue object with a self-signed certificate. Then you have a cluster issuer that you can reference to create certificates for all of your projects in your local networks. All certificates issued by this cluster issuer should be trusted by your browsers. Perfect. So let's now test this with a simple project, which I've mentioned in the beginning. Here you can see our Nginx test deployment. I've also created a service object and an ingress object that doesn't use an SSL certificate yet. So nothing really special here. By the way, you will find this example as most of my other examples on my personal GitHub repository videos. I've put you a link to this in the description down below. And now if we want to expose our application with a certificate that's obtained from our cluster issuer, we first need to create this new certificate object in Kubernetes, and we want this to be in the same namespace as our Nginx One project. So in this certificate object, we need to set a few parameters. So first we need to define how the certificate will be created, like the host name. This always needs to match with the host name in the ingress object, of course. And then we also need to add a reference to our cluster issuer object we have created, so the cert manager knows which CA to use to generate this certificate. Let's set this to Nginx One cluster issuer. Note, this object here is not the certificate itself. It's the relevant cert manager object that represents the details of a certificate. But when cert manager issues a new certificate with these details, it will store this in another secret object. So here we need to tell cert manager which name should the secret object for the real certificate have, because we need to use this later in the egress object. Let's just pick the name Nginx One TLS secret. So that's all we need to create a new certificate in Cert Manager. When we apply this now, you should see a new certificate object has been created, and you can also check the status of the certificate. If the generation was successful, you should see a new secret object that has been created with our desired name, and the certificate object will be set to true. Now, if this is existing, we can now use this secret object in the ingress as a TLS reference. Let me quickly do that. That's pretty simple. Just add a reference in the TLS settings of the ingress object. Make sure it's valid for the hostname, and then just add a reference to the secret object that should have been created by Cert Manager. Okay, let's quickly recap. We have created a certificate authority private key and certificate, stored this in a secret object, and we have used it to create a cluster issuer in Cert Manager. This cluster issuer creates a new certificate that's signed and valid for our hostname nginx1.clcreative.home, and stores this certificate in the secret Nginx One TLS secret object. And this is what we injected as a reference in our ingress object. And now if we have applied all of this stuff and refreshed it, we can open the website again in our browser. Sometimes the browser needs to be restarted until this gets active. But now you can see our Nginx One website is now exposed with a trusted SSL certificate that has been generated by Cert Manager. If you inspect it, you can also see the details of our generated CA that we have uploaded to Cert Manager. It's trusted by my computer because we have imported it in the trusted root CA store. We can now securely access this service in Kubernetes. And now that we have deployed this self-signed CA for our internal network, this can be used for any service or application in the same way. So here you can see I've used it for Portainer or for Rancher. It's all working. The Cert Manager will always make sure we get a generated SSL certificate, and if it's expiring, it will automatically regenerate it and update it in the service. That's really, really cool. As I said, in the future, we might take a look at some automated services and tools to generate CAs for us. There's one tool that I have in mind to take a look at. It's called SmallStep, but I still believe it's valuable to know how to do it manually and generate a trusted CA for your internal network with OpenSSL. I am doing this on all of my internal Kubernetes clusters and is working perfectly in my network. Okay, that was everything. I hope this tutorial was helpful to you. And as always, thanks everybody for watching. I will catch you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.